Spotted Reviews, and today the 2020 Advent Calendar of Christmas Horror Movies continues trucking along. This time I'm going to be taking a look at the 2012 movie Caesar and Otto's Deadly XMas. Written, directed, and starring as the titular character Caesar, we have Dave Campfield, also written by Joe Randazzo, as he and his half-brother Otto... I don't know. I gotta be honest, this is just a silly, slapsticky comedy horror Christmas movie that really doesn't have a whole lot of direction to it. There's a plot involving them, Caesar being affected by Santa from a childhood trauma, but now he has the opportunity to play Santa. Then he gets an opportunity to direct a Christmas horror movie. Then there's a Christmas Santa killer out there that's framing them by targeting subjects that they know. There's a romantic love interest that lives in her Yugo. It's kind of all over the place. This is apparently the fourth in a series of five movies from this group. Caesar and Otto, Caesar and Otto's Summer Camp Massacre, Caesar and Otto in the House of Dracula, Caesar and Otto Meet Dracula's Lawyer, this one, and Caesar and Otto's Paranormal Halloween. This is a very micro-budget, fly-by-night kind of underground production, and it very much feels like it. It's very self-aware of that at times, but does that actually forgive the sins of production in terms of camera work, lighting work, sound design, things like that? You know what? Buyer's choice on that. I'm kind of on the fence about it myself. I do like that it made fun of itself occasionally. But yeah, that didn't make it not a rough watch in places. Just a few days ago, I reviewed Bikini Bloodbath Christmas, and that had a very trauma-esque feel to it, including a cameo by Lloyd Kaufman. So I was really bracing myself for a shitstorm here, considering that this had a very trauma-esque feel to it, and it has a cameo by Lloyd Kaufman. But I will say that it did not suffer the same problems that Bikini Bloodbath Christmas did. This actually managed to rise above the temptation of having nothing but poop and fart and piss jokes in it, and actually have some fun characters that are just kind of going through the motions in a Christmas horror fashion. This is indie and this is rough, but it's not vulgar, or at least not overly so, and I really did appreciate that. I felt like I got a little bit of a reprieve here, and I was grateful while I was watching it that I was watching something as mediocre as I was. Look, here's the deal on this. Here's the long and short of it. This is basically a camera crew of friends that are going out and just having a good time, bullshitting around with a loose script and a wink and a smile, and just turning out a project to have some fun with. And that might not make the greatest watch. In fact, I dare say that it doesn't. But does it make the worst watch? Well, also, I would say no, it doesn't. And I don't really feel like saying that this is a terrible movie because, one, I don't think that it is. It's not great. It's not... yeah, it's not good, but it's not terrible. And two, when we're just talking about some friends going out with a camera and a loose script and just having some fucking fun making a silly-ass Christmas horror movie, do I really want to stand here and be the Scrooge and bah humbug all over this? Well, Santa's watching me and I don't have the heart to do that, so that's where I'm going to stop. I'm not going to say that I really recommend this movie, but if you happen to watch it or if you happen to see it in the queue there and it's something that you just kind of feel like maybe you're in the mood for some very low budget, very silly bullshit, then go for it. So that is my very oddly phrased recommendation for Caesar and Otto's Deadly XMas. Thank you very much for joining me here today. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. If you like this, please click like and subscribe. It helps me out way more than you know. Remember, next time you want to watch a horror movie, first make sure that it's good and rotted.